All right, so for the first day of class, we're going to talk a little bit conceptually about WordPress, and then we'll get hands-on right away. I'm going to write notes on the computer, and I'm going to put these notes in the network folder at the end of the day. I'll remind you where the network folder is a little bit later, but you are free to take notes on paper or on our computer. We have Microsoft Word. We have Notepad. You can take notes. Our very first idea that we're going to talk about is the two flavors of WordPress. We have WordPress.com versus WordPress.org. Let's take a moment, go to your web browser, and go to WordPress.com. So open up your web browser, any one you like. We've got all the popular ones down there, Firefox, Internet Explorer, Safari, whatever. Open your web browser and go to WordPress.com. So WordPress is software to create a website. WordPress is the most popular way at the moment to create a website. It has about 26% global market share, 27%. One more percent while I was talking. So 27% of the websites of the world use WordPress. That's hundreds of millions of websites in the world use WordPress. It has a lot of features that we'll talk about. One thing that we need to figure out early on is, do I want to build a website that's on WordPress.com or a website that's on WordPress.org? There's a difference. So I'm going to say very simply, WordPress.com is training wheels. And .org is no training wheels. I will say do it yourself. You can go to WordPress.com right now and create an account and start to make a website. And it takes care of a lot of the details for you. Via WordPress.org, it'll say, here's the software, download it, install it, have fun. But on .com, you can quickly create a website. Quick way to create a website. More powerful way to create a website.